put to any paper, there's some business that must be discussed. Adam, Sonya, on behalf of the almighty WWE champion, I apologize. The champ was tied up being fashionably late. DJ KD, please hit the champion's music, shall we?
I think we should.
The almighty WWE champion operating on his own time.
One thing you can't take away from the champ, he knows how to make an entrance.
You can't discount what Lashley is doing. Here we are, less than 2 weeks out from Hell in a Cell, and the mind games are already beginning.
I don't believe that Bobby Lashley's mind games are actually having any sort of significant impact on Drew McIntyre. Remember, McIntyre has been there and done that with Lashley.
He understands what he's dealing with.
How can anyone, any challenger, stare at the almighty WWE champion dripping with confidence and finesse as he makes his way to the ring? And how can Drew think to himself, I can beat this guy?
Right now, Drew McIntyre is one-track minded. Sign this contract, go to Hell in a Cell, and regain my championship.
Bobby Lashley not just taking time to get here, taking his time to get in the ring. He's a gentleman, right? From ladies first.
Absolutely.
At least he's doing that. And there are plenty of ladies when you're the champ with the belt.
You're going to spoil the championship life here in WWE.
Finally, Bobby Lashley. Getting in the ring and getting underway with this signing.
Like all great champions in the history of this business, custom made from head to toe, a true spectacle every time the Almighty makes an entrance.
Drew. Allow me to congratulate you on manipulating your way into once again facing the almighty WWE champion at Hell in a Cell. Adam, it is okay that we're out here, right? I mean, you're not gonna threaten us with another 90-day suspension without pay, are you? Because the almighty and myself last week, we held up our end of the bargain. From bell to bell, we were in Lashley's lounge enjoying the company of our acquaintances. So, I have a question for you. How will you reward the almighty champion for his compliance? What was it that you wanted, champ?
Drew, once you lose to me at Hell in the Cell, you won't get another championship match against the almighty ever again.
If I may add, the almighty plans on being WWE champion for a very long, long time. As a matter of fact, we were just talking about it this morning. He can't wait to bring the WWE championship back on the road, out to the almighty universe. Maybe in 20.
I accept. You can stop. I accept.
Well,
you can stop.
I appreciate the decisiveness.
Drew McIntyre will never fight Lashley for the WWE Championship again if I lose.
When you
but lose. I'm going to need something from you, champ. I want a match where no outside interference can cause the finish. I want a match where nobody else can lose on my behalf. I want Lashley versus McIntyre for the WWE Championship inside Hell in a Cell.
The almighty WWE Champion Bobby Lashley accepts your terms.
So it's official?
Hold on a second. Inside Hell in a Cell, Drew's last opportunity at the championship. Looks good. Do me a favor.
Make sure that's notarized.
Initial here at the X. Sign at the bottom.
Adam, you will have that notarized, right? Because our attorneys will make sure.
It will be official.
You know, Drew, that story you told earlier, you know, the one about the spider? It's kind of admirable that you're getting back to your Scottish roots. But what you fail to understand and what you fail to tell the people, how that story ends. If at first you don't succeed, you just don't win against the Almighty. And in reality, you accept defeat and you tuck your little kilt in between your legs and you walk away in shame. That's how this story is going to end.
It's official. Both parties have signed the contract. It appears to be official.
All right, champ. I got some last words for you. Some advice. You're not going to listen to me anyway, but I've been inside Hell in the Cell. You haven't. I was told afterwards I would never, ever be the same. And I haven't been. I know if you remembered, I flew about 15 feet off the side of that cell through a table. I went through physicality like I've never felt in my life, and I still feel it to this day. And I want you to know I'm willing to go through all of that again and inflict punishment on you like you have never felt in your entire life. I will tear the flesh from your skin with that cell. I will use every weapon underneath the ring. I don't know, man, what you believe in, but start praying. Those prayers are going to go unanswered, but you will beg me for mercy, and I will grant you mercy with a claymore right between your eyes when I take back my WWE Championship. Enjoy the next couple of weeks, and I'll see you in hell.
And I will beat you there also.